RHB today is 95% Malaysian. We get 95% of our revenue based in Malaysia. We've got three other locations outside Malaysia, but the overall plan for us is to get 40% of our revenues by 2020 from outside Malaysia. And to that end, we've been doing a couple of acquisitions to grow our presence outside Malaysia, but also increasingly growing organically in areas where we're already at. So in Singapore, for instance, we've increased our level of capitalization by 300 million Singapore dollars. And through the acquisition of OSK Investment Bank, as well as our proposed acquisition of a bank in Indonesia, we hope to be in 7 out of the 10 ASEAN countries by year end. We've signed the CSPA as we announced a couple of months ago to acquire 100% of OSK Investment Bank. And the whole logic for doing that is it provides us access to, as I've mentioned, to 7 of the 10 ASEAN countries. But importantly, also provides us access into Hong Kong as a key distribution center for ourselves. We've made very good progress. We've gotten all the necessary shareholder approvals and just waiting a couple more offshore regulatory approvals, but we should be done by the fourth quarter of this year. Teams are already working pretty hard in getting the integration together very, very quickly so that when we complete the transaction, we hit the ground running from day one. M&EC, in the context of being able to build institutions that deliver better value to our customers, I mean, we've seen progress in increasing of scale, which from a customer standpoint provides better opportunities for enjoying more innovative products, lower cost products, but also connectivity across the region. We've seen M&A used to extend geographical reach for many of our competitors, and in fact ourselves, when we spoke about the acquisitions that we're trying to make. So M&A has been a very, very important tool for domestic banks, not just in Malaysia, but across the region, to extend its reach and provide better value for its customers. As we start to see financial institutions in this region building more connected platforms, there will be pressure for some of the other ASEAN, Asian-based institutions to do similar. And so I truly believe that the confluence of many factors, increasing competition, more connected financial platforms, and a greater demand for financial institutions that can connect its customers across the region, will see more M&A going around this year. We've seen a lot of our European competitors start to scale down its exposures in the region, which provides opportunities for ASEAN, Asian-based banks, the opportunity to fill in the gaps left by some of our natural competitors. So from that standpoint, we have seen many, many opportunities, and in fact for ourselves, we've been able to expand a little bit more quicker in Singapore and in Thailand. But the downside of that is clearly the underlying broader-based capital markets have been impacted pretty negatively, clearly from the headwinds coming out of reduced trade from the crisis, as well as fluctuations in currencies and the financial markets because of what's happening in the Eurozone. We're fortunate to have a very strong domestic economy, and with the government's economic transformation program and the announced entry point projects totaling over close to 200 billion ringgit, we believe that the pipeline for project finance activities are pretty healthy. Now, because of the tenures of these projects and the nature of these projects, going to the capital markets it's very natural for it. And in fact, just over the last 12 months, we've seen some of the largest sukuks being issued to finance projects of this nature. We believe that the banking sector itself will continue to show pretty good growth. Again, this year, even for ourselves, we are growing at a rate of about 15% loans growth for the first half of this year, and we do expect that to carry through the full year. Challenges for the year, we do see an increase in competition driving asset yields down, so margins are coming under pressure. With new regulatory order coming in through Basel III, we do expect more pressure on efficiency of capital. And with all the expansion plans we spoke about earlier, the pressure on ensuring our cost base stays efficient will be things that we'd be keeping a very close eye on.